Oh, I've been waiting for this. Bronwyn Bishop is here. Let's talk about Upgrade Albo, the man who's here to help, and geez, doesn't he have a job tonight, is Stephen Conroy. So, let's get into all of this. Bronwyn, before the debate starts, as we have discussed before with the chopper situation, technically inside the rules, the pub test clearly, and we all know what took place, okay? He's going to say it's within the rules, it's all been declared, who cares? The reality is there are very clear breaches of the ministerial code, not once but five times. And do you read anything into the specificity around the statement out of the Prime Minister's office about whether he called or didn't call
Yes, I do.
The CEO?
And first of all, the two situations are rather different because for me there was no personal benefit.
Correct.
I was going to work.
Yeah, you weren't doing it on a holiday.
No.
Good point.
And the question is more than the pub.
What about the wedding
question? Because of the
code
of conduct.
We'll get to it in a second. You have your chance.
Because of the code of conduct, and I would remind people, of course, that Gladys Berejiklian lost her job because she was found she had breached the code of conduct.
Well, and Barry O'Farrell went over a bottle of wine because in an ICAC inquiry he forgot about that as a gift. Yep. This is all declared, it's all above the rules, but I'm sorry, they're clear breaches of the code.
Well, Barry O'Farrell didn't declare, that was the problem
right
there. But this, the question of the code of conduct was very much the issue before the ICAC. Now, the difficulty here is that the Prime Minister would be the only one who could sack himself.
Well,
he's not going to do that, is
correct,
he?
Correct, correct.
But the whole juxtaposition of being the minister in charge of being the regulating minister for the airline. And all of this comes in the juxtaposition with the house having been bought, with the treasurer anxious to push out his line on inflation, not getting any clear air. They'll be very unhappy campers, I can tell you that. And they'll be counting numbers. The trouble is there's three of them out there counting numbers.
Yeah.
If they had
let me
just
get Stephen
one,
in. Yeah.
Well, might be different.
All right, Stephen, why is there nothing to see here? Why does it not completely matter when, for obvious reasons, the pub test is a very different, amorphous thing, but once it starts getting applied to you, I doubt there's a politician who's ever survived it.
Yeah, look, so firstly, to all of your viewers, if you take advice from Bronwyn on the internal machinations of the Federal Caucus of the Labor Party, you're delusional. So Bronwyn can talk about counting numbers. She knows nothing about the Labor Party and counting numbers. That's the first point. Secondly, all week while this has been going on, what everyone has said is the key issue is that he phoned up and solicited from Alan Joyce. Nobody else has done that. That's the breach.
Barnaby Joyce this morning. Yeah.
Barnaby Joyce this morning said the real problem is that he's phoned up. I mean, Barnaby goes, I've accepted upgrades. Deputy Prime Minister, in charge of a lot of different things, OK?
Jeff, that was when he was
I'm not saying Barnaby
minister.
Broke any rules whatsoever, OK? So let's be clear. Well, what you've got to do is actually, for it to be referring to NAC, you've actually got to show...
Well, it's not going to end up...
Back when he was the Transport Minister between 2007 and 2013... you have to show that he somehow benefited Qantas.
But what
and
about...
you can't.
Yeah, but
there's
okay.
not one person after a week of toiling around in the trash has they said, oh, no, this decision back in 2009 when Albo favoured Qantas was because he received an upgrade back when he was minister. So no one's provided it. Single piece of evidence.
Well, hey, there are some fine people
again,
that have won gold Walkleys that have gone through the trash.
Importantly, he has now made it absolutely clear at no stage did he ever phone Alan Joyce. And I enjoyed your sophistry earlier. What about texts? What about emails? Like,
but he's trying... But see, this is my point, Bronwyn. Sorry, I don't know why I'm holding the glasses a lot tonight, but anyway. But this is my point, right? It's not about, you know, he wants to make it, did I call, right? The whole point was he could have asked his cleaner, he could have asked
the
cleaner.
The Liberals all week have made it
if
was, did
he turned
call?
Around and asked. Well, that's their argument. That's good luck, right? Now, you know, and pretty obviously I support them over Albo, but I've just got my own question here, which is, again, it doesn't matter who was contacted. If he asked for it, he's in breach.
It does matter. It
Why
matters,
does it matter?
It matters entirely.
If he asked anyone,
because
it's a breach.
The allegation.
The company is the entity.
No. The allegation's in the book.
I'm sorry. The allegation in the book makes a unsourced allegation that he called Joyce and solicited
Yeah, but
upgrades.
That's not the problem,
that's
Stephen.
That's not been categorically denied.
But that's
denied.
Not the problem. It's just shone a light on the problem.
Denied.
All right. Now, I want to get...
Brockman, as you well know, Qantas have an entire unit that deals with all of the politicians, all of their travel, etc.
Yeah, and if you
and
ask for an upgrade, you're in
Parliament,
the contravention of the rules as the Transport Minister. Isn't that the whole thing here, though,
now,
Stephen?
Now,
admittedly, we've got to go back into the Wayback Machine.
In the book,
and he, so if his own Transport Minister did it...
in the book...
Okay, go.
The allegation in the book was he called Alan Joyce. That's not categorically ruled out.
Okay.
And the way the system works is you phone up, and Bronwyn will back me up on this, you phone up the phone number and you make your booking, and then you... Sorry, no.
Yeah, but hang on.
Did
you, but also,
or did
the
you
Prime
get
Minister,
your staff
when asked
it?
About it yesterday,
did
could have said no, hell no, if that's what he knew it to be. The fact that he had to double-check in his memory here, Bronwyn, would suggest he had to make sure that everyone got their story straight.
Well... it's not going to go away, that's the thing.
A great bit of conspiracy theory.
Okay. Ask me, have I ever called Alan Joyce to get an upgrade in my life?
Not
answer,
a single
no.
Fact.
He did not say no. I call and all the rest of it here. All right, other stuff I want to get to. Let's talk about inflation. Reserve Bank, we are in a per capita recession. They have to cut interest rates. I know that presents some political alleged upside for the federal government. I don't think so. Stephen... We're at that moment now, but we keep hearing that the goalposts are now core inflation, not overall inflation. And let's be honest, one of the ways we're getting
headline... Core inflation, where's that in their mandate?
Well, but also, you know, the government's...
They've actually got a mandate that doesn't say core inflation or trim inflation. They literally are moving the goalposts because they've made mistake after mistake after mistake. They pushed them too high. They've pushed us into a per capita recession. And now, when all the statistics show that inflation has come down from 7 or 8%, down to inside the target range. I go, no, the target range doesn't apply to inflation. It applies to trimmed inflation, or the new word from Angus Taylor, brilliant, brilliant gentleman. He says the core inflation, without defining what core inflation is.
Which
is it?
The trimmed
is it that the same as trimmed inflation?